wrong to separate between leadership and authority. It's a, this is a big subject. We're not going to into it now. But let's take about authority. Let's talk about authority for now. And when I talk about authority, I mean a boss, CEO, your manager, government, father, mother, teacher, school principal, your direct supervisor, the chairman, whomever you consider to be in a position of authority. People lose confidence and trust in authority in two situations. Number one is when they see that authority, or whom they call leaders, is not competent. They don't know how to do the job. The boss doesn't know how to be your boss. The CEO doesn't know how to run the company. The government is not running the country. Your father or your mother or your teacher or your school principal or whoever you consider as boss, quote unquote, the way people talk about it, leader, they don't know how to do their job. How does that manifest itself? It manifests itself through the continuation of the problems that they're supposed to solve, they're entrusted of solving, and when they create more problems. So you expect your manager to manage. When your manager is not managing, right? Instead of creating harmony, efficiency, effectiveness, is creating more waste of resources, conflict, tension, mess, chaos, then your manager is not doing the job. Then there is an issue of competence. When the government is not solving the problems of the country, and as a result of that, people are suffering, and in spite of the chances that the government is being given, one after the other, you know, 1 month after the other, 1 year after the other, opportunity after the other, and still problems are not being solved, then the people will lose trust and confidence in the government, because they're delivering on the expectations of the constituency, of the people, whom they trusted that this authority will have enough competence to know how to solve the problem, at least some of the problems. Because let's assume some problems are too complicated, and let's assume the conditions for solving some other problems are not there, but definitely some of the problems can be solved. And when the message is made to the authority, to your boss, to the chiefs, to the government, to your parents, to whatever that you consider authority, that listen, there's a problem, and even you go as far as suggesting to authority what to do and showing them the way and giving them hints and telling them this is the option and that's the option, right? So you're participating to the problem solving mechanism, and they're not exercising authority to solve the problem, then of course there's a lack of trust. And then it becomes complicated, and a new dynamic starts, and frustration happens, and eventually, if the problem is not solved, the lack of trust, then there's going to be a big issue. Either there's going to be an explosion, or there's going to be a suppression, or tyranny, or a revolution, or something bad will happen. Because, you know, tension is just building up. Now, that's one. The other case is when there's no mismatch of the value system. And in this case, government, boss, authority, manager, supervisor, father, mother, whatever, teacher, principal, they know how to do the job, they're competent, but they don't follow the same value principles that you follow. And what do I mean by value principle? I mean their priorities, what they really care about. So if you have a very competent boss who is so smart but is really focusing all their attention on their own interest at the expense of the organization and yourself, then you have a problem. If you have a CEO so smart but is looking after, you know, the policies and the plans that serve his or her interest at the expense of what's best for the company, then you have a problem. When themselves is a priority at the expense of the people whom they're managing, that's when you can have a problem. When you feel from inside and you see the evidence of that, that this government does not care, your boss does not care, your manager does not care, your mom or dad does not care, your school principal, your teacher does not care, you feel that. It's not a matter of competence, it's a matter of commitment, loyalty, and values to the task, to the mission that they have been entrusted with, and that is to take care of you and make sure that they're running the situation or the, you know, the environment or the ecosystem or the organization, whatever that is, in the way that serves your interests first, the constituency, the students, the staff, the employees. So every time you see that there's tension between staff and their boss, or staff or people and their government and family members with their, you know, parents, it's one of these cases. Either there's lack of confidence in their competence, or their lack of competence, lack of confidence and trust in their value system, in what they really care about. And it's, this situation is so common. It is so common. Now, having said that, sometimes people become unfair in their judgment of their authority, because usually most people simplify things or look at situations in a far simpler way than they really are. So people tend to complain that the government or the boss or the manager or my CEO or my parents or whatever, the school, the teacher, is not meeting my expectations in solving the problem as soon as I want them to. And that coming from your lack of understanding of the complexity of the issue, or that it's not really entirely in their hand, or that you, as part of the whole problem, you're not doing your share, or there are not enough resources, or the timing is not right, or all the elements that will help the problem be solved are not there. So you have to keep that in mind as well, because sometimes people oversimplify the things and they exceed, you know, a fair level of expectation from their bosses. But it's a common problem. So when you want to analyze, every time you look, you see a situation like this, lack of trust, you have to take what I've just said into account and make sure that your diagnosis is proper so that you can come up with the right conclusions.